Welcome to Overbrook's live stream for the boys basketball game versus Eastern Regional High School.
On a Saturday.
Good afternoon and welcome to Overbrook High School. Tonight's contest, the Vikings of Eastern against the Rams of Overbrook. At this time, if everyone could please rise for the playing of our national anthem. And now, introducing the Vikings of Eastern. Freshman forward, Damian Edwards, number 5. At guard, number 20, freshman Sam Winsett. Also at guard, junior, number 10, Shane Hubbard. And number 4, forward, senior Zade. And rounding out the roster, center, number 1, senior Zubair Lee. And now for your Rams of Overbrook. At 0, guard and forward, freshman Jalen Hornsby. Number 13, sophomore guard, David Haywood. Number 14 at guard, sophomore Devin Johnson. And at center, senior number 21, Kenny Wanico. And at guard, number 12, number 1, senior Damian Rawls.
So this is our first game with some commentary, so we're excited about this.
Big game against Eastern.
Big game against Eastern. Yep. I graduated from Eastern, so nice little alma mater.
Eastern's head coach, we have Kevin Crawford, and assistant coach is Art Ellis. Another fun fact is Mr. Rosser, our head coach, is coached by Kevin Crawford as a freshman.
Yes, so Coach Rosser's freshman year, he was coached by Coach Crawford. And when Rosser was a freshman, Art Ellis, the assistant coach at Eastern, was one of Rosser's teammates. So lots of connections to Eastern. Yes, Eastern has only played one game so far this season with a loss to Shawnee High School.
Shot by senior Zubair Lee.
Overbrook is currently, have a foul on this play.
Devin.
Just kidding. An injury whistle. Sophomore Devin Johnson for Overbrook seems to have gotten an issue with his mouth, but everything is good. And off we go.
I know that Coach Rosser said he's really impressed with Overbrook's defense lately, so.
Yeah, so it's definitely exciting to see them play a team in the Olympic Conference against Eastern and put that defense to the test.
Right, that'll be important today.
When we spoke to Damian Rawls yesterday, he was also impressed with the team defense, a senior at Overbrook. Brooks, Jalen Hornsby.
Freshman starting varsity.
Very exciting for him. Overbrook's boys basketball program is very competitive to earn a spot. So.
Yeah.
And two for Jalen Hornsby.
Overbrook on the board. Off the shoe, number 10. Shane Huggard from Eastern.
Bear Lee for Eastern will go up for two shots.
Miss foul shot by Zubar Lee. One, Damian Rawls, senior.
Yeah, and Damian has been getting some interest from some D3 colleges to move on, play post-high school, and he graduates in June. So that's exciting for Damian. I know senior Kenny Winico is also getting some D3 looks. Speaking of Kenny Winico, I believe he just fouled.
To be an exciting game, ladies and gentlemen.
It already is. This is great.
Did we say that you also? Oh, we did
a block
say that you went
with
to
Kenny
Eastern.
Winico. Yes.
Kenny Winico led the division, right, in blocks last year.
I believe so. Yes, averaged 2 a game.
His height is definitely a great asset to the Overbrook team.
Foul on Eastern's number four, Zayed Lee. Zayed Lee. And Jalen Hornsby will go for two.
Jalen Hornsby.
Oh, we're subbing in. Eastern is subbing in number 23, Sakai Hill. And
10,
number 10.
Shane Huggard.
Who came in for Shane Huggard? I didn't see the number yet. Number 13, Grant Yeager.
Ball.
A high pressure defense there.
Totally.
Caused a turnover. We lost. All right.
This layup by Damian Rawls. Shot by number 20, Sam Winslow. There's 3 minutes and 18 seconds left in the first quarter.
Penny Wanika going for the three and makes it.
That is senior Kenny Wanico.
Foul on Jalen Hornsby of Overbrook, and Zubair Lee will go to the line. Coming in is Dylan
Dixon for Jalen Hornsby.
Dylan is also a sophomore. Young team Overbrook has here.
Yeah, it is a young team, but that's good. Upcoming season, I believe. Hollywood Haywood, as he was called on the football team.
Yes, he did play football at Overbrook. His nickname was Hollywood Haywood. Fun fact.
Fun fact. We're chock full of them, guys.
Speaking to Coach Rosser and Damian Rawls about the team, they were talking about how they've been, how last year they graduated so many seniors, and the emphasis on having a young team, bringing them united to really work together to have another successful season. Missed three from Devin Johnson, but Penny Wanico with the rebound.
Building that team dynamic is definitely important for a young team, and I think Damian and Kenny are bringing that in with their leadership, which is great to see.
Yeah, I know Coach Rosser was talking about how Damian and Kenny have really taken the lead in leading drills, and David Haywood with a layup and getting fouled on the play. So he will go to the line for one. Fouls on Grant Yezzy. David Haywood misses his foul shot. Eastern will go on out. One minute and 15 seconds left in the first quarter.
Back and forth there. That was a shot made.
Yes, by Zubair Lee of Eastern.
Scores 15-5 Rams.
There's 50 seconds left in the first. Here comes Kenny Winico. Nice shot by Kenny.
Eastern's hustling.
The foul is just called on David Haywood.
That's Zubair Lee up the line.
For two. Makes his first one.
Misses a second.
It's been so interesting with COVID because the refs don't touch the ball.
Oh, yes, right.
So the team players have to run like out of bounds or at the foul to get the ball. And another jump ball, so it should be Overbrook with 23 seconds left in the first.
Back.
Foul on the line.
Devin Johnson up at the line.
The foul is on number 33, John Thiel, and Devin Johnson will go to the line for two. Three seconds left in the first quarter. What an exciting quarter.
Right.
That's his first one.
Talked to Mr. Rosser yesterday about playing Eastern specifically because it is a team that Overbrook has played in the past. He says that playing Eastern last year has definitely switched up our philosophy when attacking their different defenses. We're going to try to move a lot more against their zone and try to attack gaps we can draw to defenders. This can result in kick out threes or create cutting lanes.
It seems like it's going well for them.
Yeah, it really
does. They
had
a great first quarter, so I know they've been working hard. I know when speaking to Mr. Rosser as well, he was saying it's been difficult this season because they only had one scrimmage due to COVID and didn't get as many practices before playing some official games. So he's mentioned, you know, they have been coming out slower. So it was good to see them coming out pretty strong in that first quarter.
Right.
Hello. Oh, no, no.
Mm-hmm.
Vikings were on for the second quarter, and Eastern will start with the ball. Oh, Kenny with the block. Oh, but she barely got the rebound and got it in.
Number one, Zubar Lee.
Mr. Rosser did say that was one of the players that they were looking out for, and knowing they had to defend from playing them last year.
Correct me if I'm wrong, but are number one in four twins? Or do they just look very, very similar?
Well, they do have similar, the same last name. So they have to be twins,
related,
right?
In some way.
Or related in some way.
And their height alone.
They are the same height.
Quite literally.
7 feet tall. And he's on the ground.
Oh, Jaden Greer.
And gets it off. Oh, man. Jaden Greer.
Jaden Greer, freshman, getting some play time.
Yeah. Nice to have someone to come off the bench for, you know, here and there to help relieve the players. Jaden's super nice kid.
Yeah, really nice.
I'm glad he's getting a shot.
Missed three by Zayden.
With the rebound, Damian Rawls pushing the floor and gets the layup.
That's the two. Go Damian Rawls, number one.
Damian also has a nickname, Damian the Claw Rawls.
Damian does have a nickname, Damian the Claw Rawls. He had a little injury last year and he had to shoot with his two fingers taped together for a little bit.
So it looked as though he was shooting with a claw. Sakai Hill. We're just under six here in the second quarter. Eastern definitely came out with some picked up intensity.
100%. I think Eastern saw what Overbrook is coming with and is bringing back.
Oh. Shane Huggard with the block on David Haywood, and David Haywood comes behind and knocks it out. Eastern's ball.
17-10 Rams.
And Jalen Hornsby just came in for David Haywood. Go. Gotta love the Sixers.
Gotta love the
Great
Sixers.
Great season, yeah. Major Sixers fans over here, so. Lee with the layup. Devin tried to get it to Dylan, couldn't catch it, so it will be Eastern's ball. A sub, David Haywood is back, subbing in for Dylan Dixon. Strange to be sitting in an empty gym and only having players and no spectators.
Right, especially for the basketball game, so it was brought out so much support. So it's good to see the boys still hustling out there, despite the lack of spectators. Damian Rawls, super missed.
Oh, it seems like we have a foul on the play, so we'll stay. A push on blue number 5.
Damian Edwards.
On the floor, so there will not be a shot.
Damian Edwards is also a freshman, I believe. Of the table.
Nervous for you.
Touch and go there for a minute, guys. I didn't know.
Oh, and a steal for Hubert Lee from Devin Johnson. 3 minutes left in the second quarter. Shot is no good. Hollywood Haywood. This is Mr. Rosser's 4th year coaching at Overbrook. His 1st year coaching, he was the freshman coach, 3rd year as the boys' head coach. And they found quite a lot of success in the past 3 years.
I would agree.
He did also coach at Sterling and Creighton, each school for a year, and was the freshman coach there. And Jalen Hornsby with 2.
Got a little back and forth here, folks.
Yes. Kenny with the block. Going down to Damian Rawls. Oh, he gets fouled on the play and will get the basket will count and he will go to the line for lunch. Is on number 4, Zayd Lee. Zayd Lee will be resting along with Damian Edwards, Shane Huggard, and Grant Yezzie are back in. The minute and 15 left in the second.
Number 10,
Shane Huggard. Minute left in this first half.
It's flying by.
It really is. High action today.
Right.
Oh.
Missed two by David Haywood.
Devin Johnson puts it up. But in foul.
Get there, but does get a foul.
The foul is on DeBarely. Devin Johnson, this is his first shot. Makes his second.
Brings the score to 29-19.
Overbrook up by 10 with 40 seconds left in the first half. Welcome back for the second half. Overbrook will start with the ball for this half.
Overbrook's ball. So we talked to Mr. Rosser again about some struggles he's been facing due to COVID, and he has said the toughest part is choosing which players will go to games and who won't.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Since they're limited to 22 people for away games, it's difficult for him to take.
Yeah. It happened to me. I'm the head girls soccer coach. It's definitely a difficult decision. Because the kids come and they put in a lot of hard work, and then you have to say, oh, you can't go to the game because of limited spots on the bus. He was also saying COVID affected the season. It's a shorter season, as we mentioned before. They only play 12 games, and I think they usually play about 20. And there's no state championship. Shane Huggard for the three, and hits above.
And I believe he said he had a lot less kids try out this year.
Yeah.
It's
hard to get paperwork. Yeah, or students don't feel comfortable. So definitely facing a lot of challenges. But again, they're off to a great start. Devin Johnson for three, and it's good.
Sophomore Devin Johnson
currently has all eight, something that should totally be shouted out.
Right.
A lot of have been struggling academically this school year, and so it's good to see Devin is staying on top of his work virtually. Steven Rawls and Miss Leia hustling back on defense. Damian Edwards with a missed three. Shane Huggard will try and will airball it. On Kenny, number 21, and Zubair Lee will go to the line for two.
At the line for two?
Yes. He makes the first one. Misses the second, and a rebound by Jalen Hornsby. Devin Johnson for a quick three, and misses it. Fast movement there by Belize, but a foul will be called on Kenny Winico.
Zubair up at the line again for two.
Sakai Hill is coming in for number five, Damian Edwards for Eastern.
Mm-hmm.
5 minutes and 50 seconds left in the third quarter. Damian in for the layup.
Nice hustle to the basket there by Damian Rawls.
Again, the foul is on Damian Ross.
Makes his first shot.
Second one.
Let's go, Blue Lockout! Lockout, God! Lockout, Blue! Fantastic!
No rolls for the two. Damian Rawls. Oh, here we go.
He brings the ball.
Oh, steal. A carry for Jalen Hornsby. Johnson.
Push. Devin's first foul.
Mm-hmm. With two.
Mm-hmm. Damon Rawls at the line for two. Zubar is 6'7".
Wow.
Wow is right.
I have no other words.
We were talking during the halftime about how his wingspan just looks insane.
It's insane. Like, the wingspan's intimidating as a
run for their money.
Yeah. He's the same height as Kenny, but you have both Lee brothers. Let's hope they're brothers. Zubair and Zayn are definitely the same height. So, oh, Devin Johnson
by Devin Johnson.
So to have both wingspans of Zubair and Zayd on defense definitely benefit for Easton. Foul on Damian Rawls.
There about was Zaidly. Missed shot by Zaidly.
And number 23, Sakai Hill, will go to the line for two. Makes his first one. Dylan Dixon is subbing in for Damian Rawls.
Damian's trying to go for his 1,000 points this season.
Oh, yes. Yes. He's 246, I believe he said, away. He had 36 in their first home game. Oh, David Haywood is stripped of the ball. He's with the full court press to get back on the board for two. A minute and 54 left. Timeout called by Coach Rosser, full timeout.
We're at 43-34 Rams.
Wow. Mr. Rosser really said a lot yesterday when we were talking to him that he was hoping that they would come out and be able to compete from beginning to end. Eastern's known for having high quality athletics, very competitive at Eastern Regional High School. I played soccer there. So for him, Mr. Rosser, he just wanted to prove that they can hang with the best of the best in South Jersey, and they are definitely doing that today.
I believe so. He said they have a lot of smart, disciplined, fundamental role players that will make the game quite difficult.
Yeah.
Competitive, which is great.
That it's been definitely competitive. They're only up by 9 at this point, so definitely going to be battling until the end here.
I believe the JV game was also quite competitive. They said they lost by 1 point.
By 1 point?
By 1 point.
Oh, wow. I was at the freshman game as well, down next door at the middle school, and they lost only by, I believe it was 6 or 7. With 3 minutes left, they were only down by 4. So it's been a good game for, good competition for Eastern and Overbrook for all three levels.
A nice Saturday basketball competition.
Yeah.
Jalen Horns.
Dylan Dixon steps out of bounds. This is number 12, Isaiah Yeldell is in. Overbrook's ball. Jason Kenny Winiko with the turnover to Zade Lee. Jalen Hornsby with the rebound. Dylan is tying his shoe before taking his shot. Offensive, 20 seconds left in the third. Is up by 10, 44-34.
We asked Mr. Rosser and Damian Rawls yesterday who Damian Rawls is number one, correct?
Mm-hmm.
What their hopes were for the season, and they both said, quote unquote, to win.
They did both say the exact same thing. And
not
just like that,
they said that,
to win.
Right, to win.
Yeah, we had asked Mr. Rosser earlier in the day, and we asked Damian right before they practiced yesterday, and we, Damian said, to win. And we said, oh, you and Coach are clearly on the same page. We asked Damian, Damian's a senior, so he's had Mr. Rosser as a coach for most of his time here at Overbrook. He says, you know, he really likes playing for Coach Rosser, he really knows his stuff, he's always organized, has a game plan for every practice, every game.
And constantly pushing the boys to be better.
Yes. And not just better basketball players either, but better students and people off the court as well. They're
correct.
Having mandatory study halls. If you have a D or an F, you're required to attend to complete your assignments and stay on track. So it's definitely teaching them responsibility and accountability as well.
Building better humans along with better basketball players.
And he's doing a great job.
Gets the ball back.
Jalen Hornsby for for two. Gets the rebound, goes up, and is fouled on the play. John Thiel and Isaiah Yeldo.
And Grant Yazzie misses the second shot.
Jalen Hornsby with the rebound. Damian Rawls to David Haywood, who misses. Drives to the paint and gets his layup.
Bringing that Overbrook 48.
And Eastern. Called a timeout, a short timeout, and 30 seconds. Minutes left in the fourth quarter. This game is really going quickly today.
It really is. It is 12:45.
Eastern will bring the ball in. Called on Isaiah Yeldo, and Devin Johnson will go to the line for two.
When we talked to Mr. Rosser, he had complimented Devin on his great shooting and also said he's a great rebounder for his size. I believe Devin is 5'10".
Yes, that is what Mr. Rosser, I believe, noted. This is the first one. I think one thing that's always exciting about watching Devin is he's always like locked in. Like he's always excited and engaged, even when he's on the bench. And this is his second. Kenny Winico with the rebound. Misses his layup. David Haywood with the next rebound. And Overbrook will get the reset. Johnson for three, and he makes it.
Bringing Overbrook 51, Eastern 34.
To Bear Lee.
And Kenny Juanico.
Having a great defensive game. fouls called against Isaiah Yeldell for a block. Called it before the shot, so it'll be on the floor. Shane Huggard and Zade Lee are back in for Eastern. Kevin Johnson for another three, and he makes it. It's the great shooting, Mr. Rosser.
Shooting, right?
Overbrook is now up by 20. With 5 minutes and 40 seconds left. Damian Rawls almost took us out over here.
That's right. Our former student, too, trying to take his, both of us.
Yeah. We can't change your grade now, Damian. Shane Huggard with a three. It'll be Overbrook's ball.
I think Damian had mentioned yesterday how he was, Overbrook was playing a team game, and I think that's really evident today that they're playing a very, very team-oriented game where everyone's trying to get a piece of that ball and get some points on the board, which is nice to see.
Fouled on play, so he'll go line for one.
Jalen Hornsby on the line for one.
Misses it. Kind of a Nico close with the rebound, but Benson will come away with it.
Nice to see Kenny has become such a developed player since I first started watching him play basketball.
Yeah, definitely put in a lot of work outside of just the season, and it's definitely paying off for him.
Right.
Want to know a fun fact? I played basketball at Eastern my freshman year of high school. Yeah. Sat that bench and got 8 points for the whole season.
A record for Miss. You could have really been something.
If only I could have had hand-eye coordination.
She's got the height, ladies and gentlemen, but apparently not the hand-eye coordination. I have neither.
Overbrook is now in 1-1. So Sakai Hill will go to the line. He will miss his first one, so Jalen Hornsby with the rebound. Kenny Winico with the rebound and gets two. Sabara Lee is fouled on the play and will go to the line for two.
That was the first one.
Mm-hmm. makes a second. Johnson will go to line for two. Second. 3 minutes left in the fourth quarter. Overbrook has 60 and Eastern Vikings have 37. David Haywood with the steal. Makes his layup.
Overbrook 62-37.
Devin Johnson is called for a foul, blocking foul. So Eastern's number 20, Sam Winsett, will go to the line. Misses his shot. Strong defense from Eastern's number 23, Sakai Hill, causing a turnover from Jalen Hornsby. Number 15, Eli Block, is now in for Eastern. Rebound and gets another foul. So he'll go to the line. Kenny Wanico is called for the foul. One minute and 50 seconds left. Freshman Nick Johnson coming in for Overbrook, sophomore Justin Galda, and Dylan Dixon making an appearance again.
For Kenny Wanico, Damian Rawls, and Hollywood Newman.
Jerry Lee will make it, his foul shot.
Hey!
shot blocked from Jabari Lee. And number 12 will get the layup.
Isaiah Yelda.
Miscommunications on Overbrook there. A minute and 15 left. Jump ball will be Overbrook's ball.
Overbrook Wednesday, that will bring their season to what, 3-0?
Yes, 3-0. Great start.
Right. A 12-game season, too.
Yes. So, a little more pressure on the season.
Definitely. Oh, Justin Baldo loses the ball to 20.
Johnson with the foul. Isaiah Yelda will go to one.
Shot.
This is first one. Damian Edwards is not in. Zubair Lee is now out with 38 seconds left in the fourth quarter. This is the second one. For Eastern. Running clock. We have about 25 seconds left in the fourth. Jalen Hornsby trying to hit Devin Johnson. 10 seconds left in the game. Eli blocked with a missed three. And that will be game.
Okay, folks, thank you for spending your Saturdays with us.
Yes. Wow, we did it. Oh, we did some commentary.